Hey, what's up everyone? This week I have a cool new topic for you because we are going to talk about mocks. I'm going to show you how to implement a mock and you're going to see just how useful they can be. So let's get started by taking a look at this code. As you can see, this is the code of a very simple view model which provides an array of movies that the view controller will be able to display on the screen. But what's important to notice here is how this view model has been architectured, because as you can see, the view model doesn't actually know where the data is coming from. For that, the view model relies on a service. This service is injected when the view model is created, and then inside the method fetch data, the view model is going to call the method getMovies on the service, and it will deal with the result. So if it's a success case, it will set the array of movies, and if there has been an error, it will set the error. And this pattern of architecturing our code into layers is a very good practice because it's a great way to split responsibilities across our code base. And so here, if I take a look at the code inside my service, as we can see, it is indeed the job of the service to make the actual network call that will fetch the data. But there are actually a lot of situations where it would make a lot of sense not to make a network call and instead just return a set of hard-coded data. For instance, if you are writing a unit test, you definitely want that unit test to always execute with the exact same dataset. And of course, as you can imagine, this is exactly where a mock is going to come into play. With a mock, we're going to be able to implement, we could say, an alternate version of our class MoviesService that will implement the exact same API, except that this time, this API will not be performing a network call, but instead it will be returning a set of hard-coded data. So let's get started and let's implement this mock. The first thing I need to do is to implement a command protocol for both my class MoviesService and the mock I will implement. I'm calling this protocol MoviesServicing, and for its requirements, I'm just going to copy and paste the signature of the method getMovies. Then I'm going to update my class MoviesService so that it also conforms to the protocol MoviesServicing. And finally, I'm going to implement my new class, so MoviesMockService. Of course, I'm also going to make it conform to the protocol MoviesServicing. And after that, all that's left to do is to implement the body of the method getMovies. And it's going to be pretty easy to implement. First, I'm going to paste the code of an hard-coded API response. So there it is. And then I just have to call the completion handler. I pass in a success case and I give as an argument my hard-coded API response. And that's it. My mock service has been implemented. Now we are almost ready to use it in a test. I just need to do one last modification. And that modification is that I need to go back into my view model and in the init. So at the point where we inject the service, I need to update the type. It's no longer a movies service, but it's rather a movies servicing. So the protocol that is common to both the actual movies service and the mock movies service. And of course, I also need to update the type right here. And now it's time for us to go into our testing code and actually write a test that will use the new mock service in order to test the behavior of our view model. So in my test, first, I'm going to instantiate my mock service. Just after that, I'm going to also instantiate my view model. And as you can see, I am injecting as a service my mock service. Then I'm going to execute the code that I want to test. So here is the method fetch data of my view model. And finally, I'm going to implement an assertion. Here, I want to assert that after calling fetch data, inside the variable movies of my view model, there are actually three values. And I can use this hard-coded three right here because I know that my mock service will always return an array of three movies. And so let's run the test to make sure that indeed it succeeds. And as you can see right here, just as we expected, my test did succeed. So that's already a great result because thanks to our mock service, we are now able to test our view model because we can rely on the fact that when we inject our mock service, our view model will always operate with the exact same dataset. But now I want to show you how we can take things even further. And for this, I'm going to go back into my view model. I'm going to do something that might seem a little bit stupid at first glance. I'm going to copy the call to my method getMovies on my service. I'm going to paste it just below. So I've essentially duplicated the call to the method getMovies. Of course, this looks pretty silly in such a simple example, but this kind of situation can actually happen quite easily in real life. When we are refactoring code, it's actually pretty easy to do a bad copy-paste that will result in that kind of duplicated calls. And of course, it would be pretty great if we could write a test that could detect that kind of duplicated calls. Right now, if I run my test, the duplicated call will not be found out because, as you can see, each call is going to set a new value for the array of movies. And so if I go back to my test and I execute them, they're still going to succeed because at the end of the call to fetch data, there is still three movies inside my array of movies. So how could we test that the method getMovies of our service was called once and only once by the method fetch data of our view model? What we need is basically a way to track how many times the method getMovies has been called on the instance of my service. So to implement it, I'm going to go back to the code of my movies mock service, and I'm going to add a new property to my mock. So I'm going to call it getMoviesCallCounter. I'm going to give it an initial value of 0. And then at the beginning of every call to the method getMovies, I'm just going to increment this call counter. And with this call counter now implemented, my test becomes quite easy to write. I just need to assert that on my mock service, the call counter is equal to 1. This way, it will assert that the method fetchData of my view model has called the method getMovies of the service once and only once. And so if I run my test again, this time the test should fail because it should detect that the method getMovies is currently being called twice by mistake. So let's go ahead. And as you can see, my test has failed. The error message says xctassert equal q is not equal to 1. So my test has indeed been able to detect the duplicate call to the method getMovies. So I'm going to go back to my code to fix it. So I just need to remove the duplicate call right here. And now if I go back to my test and I run it again, we are going to see that this time it's going to be all green. Perfect. So for this video, I'm going to stop here, but you could actually go even further with this approach. For instance, if I go back to my service, let's say if I also add an argument inside the call to getMovies, I could totally add another property to my mock. So it would be, for instance, getMoviesArgValue. It would be of type string unwrapped. And then at the beginning of every call to the method getMovies, just like I had been incrementing the call counter, I would also be storing the value of the argument that was passed to the method inside that property. This way, I could also test that my method has been called with the expected value. And that's all I wanted to show you in this video. We've seen how easy it was to create a mock and then inject it in order to simulate a lower layer of our architecture. And we also saw how a mock makes it easy to write tests that are actually quite powerful. As always, if you have any questions about the content of this video, please feel free to ask them in the comments. Thank you for watching and see you next time.